In this vlog, we would like to deal with the implementation of PUT API request. So in our previous tutorials, we have dealt with GET and POST API request using Dio library. So in this part of the tutorial, let's try to see how we can implement PUT API request using Dio library. Basically, what is a PUT API request? We have seen GET API request is used to fetch the data and POST API request is used to create a data. That is, whenever we are trying to post some values to the API so that the record is being created. Sometimes even we create resources using the POST API call, and that again it's depending upon the API type, whether you are using a REST API. So now PUT API is used to update the data. Yes, whenever you try to create some data with the help of POST API call and you need to make some corrections in those data, then you can make use of a PUT API which will try to update the data by recreating the row again for you. So now let us try to see how this thing works in Flutter application using Dio library. So the very first thing we need to do is, like in our previous tutorials, we have already done with the basic coding for our application. So I'm just using the same code for now and just try to edit these required things so that we can able to perform PUT API request here. And also I suggest you to go through our previous tutorials so as to get an idea of how you can implement a GET API and POST API request. And it's mandatory to go through the POST API request tutorial because PUT API request is almost similar to the POST API tutorial which we have dealt. So now let's try to edit this particular API call here. Now instead of dio.get here, let us try to see what are all the options available for us. So instead of get here, let us try to see what are all the options available for us to make an API call here. So here we are having patch, get, put, and all these things are there. So now let us try to see the PUT API call. And inside the PUT API call, it will accept a URL. So yes, we have provided a URL, and also it will accept the data to be updated. So in POST API call, we have seen, right? So we need to specify the data even here. Let us try to specify name here. And let us try to specify your name. So I'm just specifying my name over here. And also specify email ID here. So abhi@email.com. So some dummy email ID I'm going to specify here. And yes, this is it for specifying the PUT API request. And as you can see in the thumbnail, so we can just create this particular API request within 1 minute. So it's so easy and so quickly we can implement the API calls in your Flutter application using Dio library. Let us try to run this particular code and see the output once. So basically PUT API call will replace the POST API call. I mean, the data which you have inserted with the help of the POST API call will be replaced with the PUT API call. So here we are having some dummy URLs here, so we cannot specifically see the data replacing here because the URL which we are using will not store any data. So these URLs are just for testing purpose. So in real time, when you make use of your APIs, I'm sure these things would work as they should. And also, for to avoid all the confusion, let us try to rename all these things here. So PUT is also called as update here. So in the CRUD operations, create, retrieve, update and delete, right? So update is nothing but PUT API request here. So let's try to add the same here, update data, and try to add it under on pressed here and try to rerun the code. So these are just minor changes, you may even ignore them. So here when you tap on update data here, what you can see, the response is similar to that of POST API here. So here you can clearly see we have got the things we have entered. So the response is quite similar to the post API, but there is a difference in post and put API. So the very first thing I want to specify here is you can even use put API request instead of post API request. Yes, because put API request will search for the data. If the data is present, it will try to update it, or else it will try to create the data for you. So that is a specialty of the put API request here. And using the post API request, you can only create the data, you cannot update the data here. So now let us try to see the same implementation with the postman here and try to observe the output here. So we have specified put as the API call here, and you can observe 200 we have got as a status code now. So whenever you make use of the post API request, you will be getting 201, right? So here we have got as 200 for now. Yes, this is it for the put API request using Dio library. And also I'll suggest you to go through the previous tutorials where we have made the concurrent API calls event. The code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And yes, this is it for this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.